Hi, welcome back. Today we are going to learn about the difference between post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and post-inflammatory erythema. In order for your favorite skincare products to actually work, you need to know the difference between the two. But first, let me introduce myself. My name is Juraj and I am the skincare stan. I love all things skincare and I am here to help you along the way on your skincare journey. When I say post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and post-inflammatory erythema, I know it sounds so scary. But in this video, I'm going to simplify it and actually give you all the information that you need to actually make the right consumer choice. What is post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation? Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation is a type of hyperpigmentation that can show up either on your face or on your body. The main thing to learn is that it usually shows up as brown, flat spots, depending on your skin type. Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation is actually caused by an overproduction of melanin, followed by an inflammation of the skin, such as acne, sun exposure, or scarring. Don't be afraid of melanin. Melanin is good. Melanin is what gives your skin its color. However, inflammation or injury can cause melanin to be produced only in certain spots. That's why when you ask me, oh, how can I get rid of my brown spots? It's usually post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. You're not after melanin, you're after PIH. So, post-inflammatory erythema is a type of hyperpigmentation that most often appears on lighter skin tones. And unlike post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, it is not linked to melanin production. After inflammation of the skin, the increase in damaged capillaries actually causes the pinkish and reddish areas appearing all over your skin. So, let's go over the two main visual differences between post-inflammatory erythema and post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Dark brown spots are post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, and pinkish red spots are post-inflammatory erythema. Another important thing to remember is that your skin type can determine the type of hyperpigmentation that you're going to get. Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation is most common in darker skin tones, while post-inflammatory erythema is most common in lighter skin tones. We need to start talking about how can we get rid of those pigmentations. The first and the most important thing to know is that both post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and post-inflammatory erythema can take a long time to go away on their own. At one point after finishing my Accutane course, my face was covered in post-inflammatory erythema and even some post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, even though I have quite a pale skin tone. And even my own dermatologist didn't warn me about the dangers of not wearing sunscreen following Accutane or having acne. Let me tell you, that hyperpigmentation took ages to go away. So, if you want to help your skin speed up their process, there are a couple of things you can do. The golden rule that is non-negotiable when it comes to post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and post-inflammatory erythema is wearing your sunscreen. Making sure your skin is protected from the sun, generally staying away from direct sunlight, is going to make sure that your hyperpigmentation goes away quicker and also doesn't get worse at the same time. Another super important thing. Even if you can't feel the warm sunlight on your face, even if the day is dark and cloudy, you still need to be using your sunscreen because the harmful UVA rays are still there. When it comes to dealing with post-inflammatory erythema and post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, minimizing UVA damage is the key thing. So even if you are at home happily typing away on your laptop next to your window, know that wearing sunscreen is still the best thing you can do to stop hyperpigmentation from getting worse or speeding up that process and making sure your face is clear as fast as possible. So let's talk my top 5 favorite ingredients when it comes to fighting post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. One of my favorites is definitely vitamin C. Not only is it going to work on brightening your complexion and getting rid of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, it's also going to help with the production of collagen that you're probably going to need after suffering from acne. I absolutely love vitamin C products by the brand Banish, not only because they are super stable and they also include vitamin E and ferulic acid in it, which means it's going to penetrate your skin better and last longer. They also offer vitamin C in three different forms. They offer a vitamin C cream, they offer it as an oil, Banish oil, which is my personal favorite, and they also offer it in toner form, which is this vitamin C beauty elixir. So whatever step of your routine you want to introduce a vitamin C in, they probably have it. And all of their vitamin C's are fresh and they actually do what they're supposed to do. The second ingredient is definitely niacinamide. Niacinamide is amazing because it offers so many benefits to the skin. It has been researched so much, and we actually know that it actually has an impact on post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, boosting your collagen production, soothing your skin following inflammation. So it's perfect for this period after you've been suffering from acne where you want to get that glow back. My favorite two products are definitely the Geek & Gorgeous Bee Balm. This is such a nice and light formulation. You can easily incorporate it into your routine. It does not have any of those ingredients that can cause irritation, like, in my opinion, The Ordinary does with their niacinamide serum. This is definitely my go-to and something I recommend all the time. If Geek & Gorgeous is not available to you, you can also use the Inkilis niacinamide. This one is really nice and hydrating. So if you have really dry skin, I feel like this one is perfect. Also, during the winter, this one is great because of its texture. The third ingredient that I love to use in post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation is definitely alpha-arbutin. Alpha-arbutin is a safe and a gentle alternative to hydroquinone, but it's actually quite powerful when used long-term. I actually always recommend alpha-arbutin by the brand Ordinary. It also has hyaluronic acid in it, so in the morning you can just cleanse, put this on and have an active ingredient and also something to hydrate your face, put some sunscreen on and you're good to go. This is definitely something that I would include in my routine if I was suffering from post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Number four is retinoids. You can cause irritation if you're overusing retinoids, so you have to be really careful to start slow. When it comes to retinoids, you should start maybe once a week for the first month, twice a week for the second month, and then top it off at three times a week for your third month and every month after. My favorite over-the-counter retinol is definitely the Geek & Gorgeous A-Game 5 or A-Game 10. You can also talk to your dermatologists about tretinoin, but be careful with this one because this is extremely potent and you have to make sure you know what you're doing, and your dermatologists need to check your skin to see if you can do this before actually starting. And the last thing is AHAs or alpha hydroxy acids. These exfoliating acids are really great at peeling off the top layer of your skin. So I really love the Banish Pumpkin Enzyme Mask. It features glycolic acid, which is one of the most powerful exfoliating acids in the AHA group. But also, if you have sensitive skin, I recommend Cheer Up by Geek & Gorgeous. It has mandelic acid. Well, we know erythema is caused by our capillaries being disturbed and being damaged, so we want to use products that are really going to let our skin rebuild. So any product that is going to calm down your skin, that is going to rebuild your skin barrier with ingredients such as organic aloe, organic green tea, and organic go-to cola. I love the Banish Fighter Gel because it has all three of these ingredients and it's been especially formulated for these kinds of problems. Another ingredient that I absolutely love to use is vitamin B5, or as you might know it, panthenol. My favorite product featuring panthenol absolutely has to be the Cicaplast Balm B5 by La Roche-Posay. It's just such a great, thick, healing balm that I put at the end of the day, and in the morning I just wake up completely rejuvenated. I actually love layering it with the fighter gel, so I first put on fighter gel and then a layer of the balm over it. And let me tell you, your skin's barrier is going to be thankful after this. And once again, we have vitamin C. Vitamin C can actually boost your sunscreen, so I love this vitamin C beauty elixir that comes in a spray, which you can use like that and then put your sunscreen over it. This is great for reapplication during the day if you want to make sure you're getting the max out of your sunscreen. The most important thing here that I want you to remember is patience. Also, stay positive. When you get your acne under control, I know that the first thing you want to do is forget all about them. Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation and erythema can be a painful reminder of what you went through. I want to remind you that pigmentation is natural and it is your skin's way of protecting your skin and healing your skin. Also, don't overwhelm your skin with too many actives trying to get rid of your pigmentation quickly. You definitely don't need all of them. Save your skin and save your money at the same time. So until next time, be kind to your skin, wear sunscreen, and don't let those marks make you lose sleep. Bye!